Hey, hey everybody, this is Melina from ScrapbookingwithME.com and me, Crafty Scrapper, here on YouTube and Instagram. Today we are making ink dipped tags. They are watercolor tags. And we are putting some book page pockets on them too. This is watercolor paper. We do have this in the shop. Strathmore watercolor paper. And I'm cutting this paper down 3 inches wide. And then I will cut it down as far as the length goes too. So that got me 1, 2, 3, 4 across on that watercolor paper. Now, these are 9 inches. So if I cut them at 4.5, yep, those will be big enough to do some cute stuff on. I don't really need any big tall tags anyway. So these are 4.5 by 3 inches. So that means out of one sheet of the Strathmore watercolor paper that we have in the shop, you can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 out of one sheet. Okay, I don't know if we will finish all 8 of these or not, but I'm going to go ahead and clip my edges. I want to do the large angle. So all of my tops, I'm going to do that too. Okay, so we are going to go ahead and ink these up, get them all nice and inky. I'm also going to put some collage paper on them too. This is the Tim Holtz document collage paper. And I'm not going to cover the entire tag itself, but I am going to put some of that collage paper on. So we got to use some collage page for that. And get our silicone spreader out. And then we will get out some sprays and inks. And let's see, let's go ahead and get out varnish brass, saltwater taffy, salvage patina, some black soot, field paint, and walnut stain. All right, I have found that when I am going to watercolor a surface, especially watercolor paper, that if I will go ahead and get it wet with something, inks and stuff that I add on to it will adhere a little better. Okay, so each one of these tags is going to have a little bit, just a little book page pocket at the bottom. So I don't have to necessarily decorate the bottoms of these at all. But I am going to decorate the tops. So I'm just using up some of this collage paper. Let's go ahead and get collage page on our messy mat. We have messy mats. These are the non-stick mats. We have them in the shop. We have collage page in the shop. Lots and lots and lots of collage page, as a matter of fact. So no need to look any further for your mixed media needs. We have these silicone spreaders in the shop. We still have some collage paper, I know, but I don't know exactly which ones we have left. It might not be this particular collection. Now, Mom did some collage page index cards with pockets not too long ago on her channel, and I loved the finished product that she got. So I wanted to try my hand at something similar. And I'm just going to kind of wrap that behind. I'm not too concerned if it sticks really well or not. I'll cut it off later once all this dries. But we're just going to go through and put on this collage paper on every one of them. So I'm going to make kind of like a matching set of 8 tags and have some of the same colors that I dip them in too. So just kind of cover the entire tag with your collage page and then just line up your collage paper how you want it. Don't worry about it being straight. You're going to do other stuff to these. Okay, I'm going to run out of room to put them off to the side. Okay, let's get another piece trimmed off. That's going to be cute. So how have y'all been? Leave me a comment below. I always love hearing from y'all. I love reading your comments, and I try my best to respond to all the comments, but it is getting to where I'm having a hard time finding the time to reply to all of them, but I try my best to go through and heart all of them anyway, and then, of course, if there's a question, I try to get a night during the week where I'm just kind of sitting and answer any questions that are in the comments. But it is getting to where I'm not able to fully respond to every comment now. So, but keep commenting and I will try to keep answering and keep replying because I want y'all to stick around. And I know that if I stop talking to you, you're not going to want to stay around. So I'll try my best to still talk to you in the comments too, not just on the videos I make. Okay, rip some more. Add that there. Let's do 2 pieces. Do that piece there. And that piece there. And 3 more. Alright, I've got all of them covered like I want, and if you have watched any of my collage videos, you know that it is a messy train wreck before it is beautiful. It's gonna get better. I promise. All right, I'm going to dry some of this a little bit, just a little bit, before I start adding some ink, just because I don't want it soppy wet when I'm adding ink, because I don't want it to run in too many places. So here we go. Oh, and I mentioned Mom's video that she had done, the index card one that she did, and I will link that in my description box below if you have not watched that. And for anybody that does not know, my mom is Scrapbooking With Me Crafts on YouTube. She has been around on YouTube for several years and does quite well. So anyways, if you are not subscribed to her, please go subscribe. This is Tarnished Brass, my favorite of all time, Tim Holtz ink, spray inks, and I am just doing my favorite procedure, technique on this, and it is taking the stem out and splattering. So I'm going to do that to all of my tags, and if some of them get really big clumps, good. If some don't, that's all right too, because all of that is not going to stay as a splatter, because we're going to start smearing some of this too. I'm going to have to move these over. I'm going to get really messy inky by the time this is over with, and I'm okay with that. I have found that if I don't put gloves on, when I'm done with whatever it is that made me messy, if I will go and just put just a little bit of Clorox or bleach on my hand, just a tiny bit, and then get that all over my hands, and then wash with warm soapy water, all of it comes off very, very easily. And then of course I go and moisturize my hands too, because that Clorox really, really dries your skin out. This is the black soot oxide, and I'm just smashed it on there. I think mama called it the smash technique too. Okay, and then I've got it just a little wet with my water bottle, and I'm going to pick up all the rest of that too and just make me a little bitty black soot pool over here. And that's just one of those little Dollar Tree paintbrushes there that I just splattered all over my face. So when I come out of here, my family's going to be like, what in the world have you done to yourself? Okay, splatter and get one of my hairs off of there. Sorry, y'all had to see that. Okay, there's a little bit. Now remember, at the bottom, it's not going to be seen too much because I'm going to have pockets on here, but I'll try to do more of it at the top than at the bottom. Okay, and I'm just willy-nilly putting it in there, not really caring how it all looks. We will keep going and keep going and doing even more and more and more until all of this starts to kind of seep together. But I want to show you, we don't want it to get muddy looking. I'm going to put just a little bit more on this one. We will kind of dry in between so we don't get just a big mud puddle after we start adding all these other colors too. So I'm going to sop up this black soot that I put down there. Okay, nice neutral color, and let's get it dried a little bit on our tags. Okay, now it does not have to be completely dry. I'm just trying to get it a little bit so we don't muddy up all the colors. All right, I'm gonna do a smush or two of salvage patina. And I'm just going to barely wet that. So just one little spray and then get the pool going with my paintbrush. And I'm going to splatter with this one. And then that really just gets all over me too. But I love that color. That's salvage patina is gorgeous. And then with all of my other colors, brighter colors, not traditional junk journaling colors, I'm going to splatter them also. And then when I get to the walnut stain, then we're going to do another smear of it like we did the black soot. Okay, that really gets everywhere. But I'll get it cleaned up, and then we'll go to our next color. Now, the good thing about in between the splatter colors that we're going to be doing, you don't really have to dry anything. Now, here is that newest color, the saltwater taffy, with one good squirt in it. And then I'm going to wash off my little paintbrush and come over here and get the pool going, and then start splattering saltwater taffy. That is so pretty, and it goes really good with that salvage patina too. And then here in the States, as I'm making this video, it is springtime, so reminds me of that too. And anybody that is not into mixed media, I know what you're thinking right this very moment. It's okay. I understand how you feel. And I promise you it gets better. Stick around. All right, last splatter color, and that is the peeled paint. One spray. And then make the pool, and then get to splattering. This one's going to show a lot because I don't have that much collage paper on it. Now, that collage paper, if you don't have that specific type of paper, you can use tissue paper or napkin, whatever you would like to do. Oh, I know you can't see these up close, but they look good, y'all. I love the splatter. And I love that green. It looks really good. So I'm going to leave that there. I'm going to do our walnut stain pool down here, but I'm going to dry these just a little bit because the walnut stain will be one that I dip in like I did the black. All right, now with the walnut stain, I'm really going to try to cover up some of the white that's showing on the tops of some of these because, like I said, the bottoms are going to be covered up with book page pockets. So here's my walnut stain down here. I'm going to spray it up and I'm going to pull this up some so y'all can see that. Make my pool. Okay, I need a little bit more. I'm going to dip the top and then let it run where it shall, and then dip the top and let it run. I'm loving these. And if you're not into messy mixed media, this might not be the video for you to be watching. Anyway. Okay. I really want the tops to be dark and cover up that watercolor paper. Okay, I'm going to add some more smudging over here. Spray and get the pool going again. One more time. See if I can't get a good run going. Can always spray these a little bit if you've got a color that's too pooled up somewhere. I'm using the word pool a lot in this video. Okay. Spray that some and get that to run. Okay. And then last one. And then I've got lots and lots of pooling here that I want to kind of get going somewhere else, but I don't want it to look like I've tried to watercolor on my tag, so I want it to kind of be abstract looking. There we go. And I like that kind of cracked look. I'm going to leave that alone. I like those spots. I'm going to leave that alone. I'm going to cover up some of these white areas, and then I'm really hating that I'm going to lose all this whenever I put that pocket on. I like that up there, so I'm going to leave that alone. All right, and then I dip into my green because I love this color so much, and pop a little bit of that at the top with some splatter, and then go in and dry them, and then we'll trim up any pieces that needs to be trimmed before we start putting on our book page pockets. This one's getting muddy right in the middle, so I'm going to let it come off. Just so it won't get too muddy, and I'll put some more green at the top there. Okay, now I'm going to start drying. Okay, while they continue to dry, I'm going to trim off my excess collage paper off of all of these. I'm just going to trim it off. Some of it, I guess I could have just torn off, but I'm going to get it all off what I'm not going to use. And these are a little bit darker than what I was going for, but I have an idea on how to remedy that in just a minute. So I'm going to leave that collage paper on there because it's pretty much on there, stuck and good. I like that the words from the collage paper is just barely showing through on most of them. I love that. I just wanted that to be a hint in the background. I love how mixed media feels once you have dried it well and you're pretty much done with, you know, getting everything wet after it's dried. I just love that feel. That is like, that's my favorite. Okay, I'm going to put down some more peeled paint. And I'm going to just barely wet it. Barely get a pool going because I want it pretty strong. On there. Yep. I like that. So we'll have to do that a couple of times so that we'll have enough ink. I like that. That's a lot better. Last things to make them wet, and that is the saltwater taffy oxide spray and then the picket fence distress spray. All right, so I'm going to splatter with saltwater taffy to brighten that up just a little bit, lighten it up just a little bit. And I'm okay with big globs. You can always go back with a paper towel if something got too blobby on you. And y'all are gonna see. Y'all will love these when I get done. Just right now, they're still wet. And all that oxide ink is still going places. So we got to wait for the dried, finished product. Picket fence is really going to stand up on top of everything. And then kind of mingle in with it too. Alright, lots and lots and lots of splatter everywhere. We'll let it dry and then I will come back and show you what they look like. Now, I'm going to put these off. Now, until you see these up close, you are not going to appreciate all the color that I got out of those. Sorry, I'm leaning over and making sure none of them are touching. Before I come back here and spray off my mat, let's get that cleaned up and get my hands a little bit cleaned up. And then we're going to start working with our book pages. I've got just random book pages that I took out from different books I have over here on my shelf. And we're going to cut them down. So I need my hands a little cleaned off. We're going to cut those book pages down to add to our tags. Okay, so they are, our tags are 3 inches wide. So we need to cut these book pages down to go on there. And we're going to double the book page up. Alright, so I'm going to cut into the wording a little bit on both sides. And we're going to get this cut down to 3 inches wide. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is fold it up. And of course, we don't need it that tall, because our tag is not that, well, it is that tall, but we don't want it to cover up the whole tag. So I'm going to cut it down to about 2 inches. Yep, I'm going to go that far down. So 2 inches, and that's going to be on the bottom of our tag, and I'm going to double it up so we can go ahead and glue these together. And what I'm going to use is some score tape, because I do not like what liquid glue does to my book pages. It makes them all wonky, and you can see all the little trails of liquid glue everywhere. So I just don't like liquid glue on my book pages. So I'm going to use some double-sided tape. This is just score tape. If you have the kind that comes out of the dispenser, use that. And then I'm just putting these together. And then we'll use 1/8 inch score tape to put our pockets on the actual tags. So I'm just folding this over like that. And then we'll add this to the tag. I'm going to ink these. Let's do walnut stain, since we've got that in our tag itself with all the inking and mixed media we were doing. And then we can add a little label or something like that also to these little pockets. So if you wanted to add a little number label of some kind, something like that, or you wanted a word you wanted to cover up, you can do that. And then we'll add those onto our pockets once they are dry. I'm going to go through and cut all of my book pages down into these 3 by 2 inch pieces, and then we're going to put 1/8 inch score tape. And once those tags are dry, then we will add these cute little pockets onto them. I've got all of my pockets cut, and I've got them inked and taped together. Then we have some really good scraps for our scrap pile. And I'm going to get a piece of regular copy paper, and I'm going to put these on top of the copy paper, and then we are going to stamp a little bit on these. And we're using some pigment ink. This is black pigment ink. And I want to use a little bit of just messy kind of stamping. I don't want to cover up too much of my pocket, because it is book page and everybody loves book page. But I do want to cover up some of the emptiness that it has. So like that, and see, it's just barely showing on there. no big anything taken away. And then I think I'll just do that little stamp on every one of them, just to kind of have some uniform look to it and in different spots. Okay, and then this bigger one, and kind of off stamp. Oh, I like that. Over where that is, but off stamping. So you got like a little cluster of ink. Oh yeah, I like that. The polka dot part of it really stands out on this lighter book page. And let's do a little bit just in some naked spots off to the edge. Nothing too big. Like that. Yep, I like that. Just off on this edge here, and maybe stamp off a little bit. That's pretty. Might do a couple on this one since it's got quite a bit of openness on it. So we've got our pockets stamped, and that's all I'm going to do to those before we put them on our tags with 1/8 inch score tape. Now let's bring our tags up. And I'm going to ink around my tags with black soot. Most of these are dry. I'm going to just barely stamp this script stamp. It's like incoherent. You can't even really tell what it says. And I'm just going to get my rag and wipe off on the bottom, just so that it is not, so it doesn't like show up as a square. So see, I rubbed off on that, and it's just got a few of the little squiggly words on there, and it's not like a uniform, oh, that's a square stamp, you know, and nobody can tell that's what I was using. Okay, just a few little words. Okay, I'm going to do this side of the stamp on this one. Just rub off the bottom. I think I want to put this one down here a little bit. So some of the pocket will cover this up, but just so it's a little different on all of them. All of them don't need to be at the very tip top. All of our edges inked. And I think this black soot is really going to bring it out. And then if there's any of that oxide that's close to the edges, well, I'm going off into the wrong ink pad. If there's any of that oxide that's really close to the edges and gets close to this, it will do kind of that ink resist. And I love that look. Pretty. Yep. And see, you can tell the difference. You can see all of the definition when you ink edges. Alright, so first one, and I'm not going to go through those and see which ones look better with which ones. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to start adding on. Look at that. Now this one, I left a little bit of the kind of rough edge on that one side, and I'm okay if some of this some of these pockets are overhanging just the least little bit. I'm good with that. I don't think I'm gonna trim those at all, but let's add on our 1/8 inch score tape on either side and then across the bottom, and then we're going to add it on. So all the way to the bottom of the tag, and there is our book page pocket on the bottom of it, and even got a little bit of that pink off of my fingers onto the book page pocket. And then we can add little tickets or something if we want to these. And I think what I'm going to do at the tops of all of them is just staple on. I don't think I'm going to punch holes. I really like the seam binding here. That was the autumn brown that we had available in the shop at one time. We are sold out of that right now. I like that blue too. Maybe we can do some of that, because that goes along with our patina that we did. And then we can do some black also. Maybe I'll just do a couple of the blue ones, but most of them will be this autumn brown and the black. And then I'm just going to come in here and staple that on. That's one. We got 7 more to make. Put some white paper down so that y'all could see these and get a good look at them. They kind of blend into my blue mat that I have on my desk. But I think that these turned out so pretty. They are kind of like a grungy Easter egg. That's what they remind me of, because I've got the really grungy splatters and dips, and you know how we ink dipped every bit of them and then splattered them and then stamped them and then inked the edges. So they're very grungy and they are very yummy. I love these. I'm going to give you some up close shots at the end. I have got to go get all of this off my hands. I love getting messy. I love doing mixed media, but the cleanup, ooh, I have to go get this off. I can't handle that, and put some lotion on my hands. I can't wait. But I will have you some still shots at the end. Y'all have a great day. I will see you in the next video. If you make some really good and grungy mixed media tags with some book page pockets, let me know and tag me at Melina Pylant on YouTube, and let me come and find it. I want to leave you some love. I love these tags. I love the different tops that I have on each one of them. So I've got like a robin's egg blue, and then I have black, and then I have that autumn brown seam binding. And then also I wanted to mention that the autumn brown is from scrapbookingwithme.com, but The blue and the black seam binding is from Debbie at Paper Sweeties. So if you are in the market for some cute stamp sets or some wonderful seam binding, you need to go check out papersweeties.com, and I will leave the link in the description box below. That is where I've got this beautiful pink bag of seam binding, and I just love it. Also got a stamp set from her not too long ago. This one's called Beautiful. It's got some labels and wording in it. She's got some really cute stamps, y'all. Y'all need to go check those out. Y'all have a great day. God bless. See you in the next one. Love y'all. Inky, inky hands. Love y'all. Bye.